Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Williamson County Coaches Preview Show. I'm Jack Daniels, your host, and with me for tonight's game are the head basketball, girls basketball coaches at Brentwood High School, Coach Ronnie Seigenthaler, and at Ravenwood High School, Coach Matt Robinson. Welcome, coaches.
Thank you.
I'm telling you what, this is our first show of the year, and we brought some good people on here to be a part of this. Now, you've never been here before, Matt. I'm going to start with Coach Sig because he's a veteran. He's been around. He's been around a lot longer than me. But Coach Sig, just bring everybody up to date with the Brentwood girls basketball team, how you guys have been doing this year.
Jack, fortunately, we've been very blessed to have a great start. Participated in a Thanksgiving tournament, and things went well while we were at Cane Ridge. Got a look at three different teams there. We went to Beach High School during the Christmas break, the post-Christmas tournament. I always like to go there because you get a different flavor. Usually an out-of-state team. We played a local team the first round, then we played a team from Kentucky the second round, and then played Knoxville Farragut in the finals there. Those experiences have helped us, I think. And then, of course, because of the realignment of the district and adding a couple of teams, we've already started our district schedule. Typically, you wouldn't start that until after Christmas, but everybody in District 11 AAA has already played two, if not three, district games.
Okay. So your season's record right now, Coach?
We are, caught me a little off guard.
Okay.
We are 15-1.
Okay. All right. Great. Good job. That is a good start. Congratulations up to this point. Now, Matt, everybody don't know you like they know Coach Sig, so I'm going to back up here with you a little bit and say, okay. Just tell us about yourself, where you grew up, where you went to school, college, and where you've been coaching at over these few years.
All right. Well, Jack, I'm originally from Franklin, Ohio, actually, and it's kind of crazy now. I live down here in Franklin, Tennessee, but I went to Lee University, which is over close to Chattanooga, and I was a manager for the basketball program there for 3 years. And then with it being a small school, I was able to be a student assistant coach my senior year, and then I was the graduate assistant there. So I recruited, scouted, got a lot of great experience there. And then after graduating, moved here to the Nashville area, and I've been at Ravenwood. This is my ninth year, actually, at Ravenwood. So I was an assistant coach under Coach Rodney Thweet for a year, and then was assistant with Coach Whitlock on the boys' side for 7 years.
Okay.
And now here we are with the leading the girls program.
Well, is that something they had to twist your arm into doing, Matt, or is that something that you volunteered to, or you wanted just to be a head coach? I mean, switching from boys to girls got to be a little bit different.
It is a little bit different. My high school coach actually had the same transition. Coached me in high school, and then a couple years after that ended up taking over a girls program. And so this summer I was able to talk to him several different occasions, and he really gave me a lot of good advice on making that transition, and I learned a lot from Coach Whitlock and the program that the boys have built, and I thought that some of that would transition into the girls' game, and it's been a great experience. I've been really excited about it.
Okay, now I'm going to put you on the spot.
All right.
Do the girls listen better than the boys?
they do. They do listen a little bit better than the boys do, and you know, it's a great treat seeing how hard they work every day. Mm. And they do want to do everything you say, and sometimes you wish they would not always do everything you say, because sometimes there's somebody wide open under the basket. That's not part of the play, so they make the next pass instead.
Mm-hmm. So. Well, you mentioned Lee University. I'm going to throw this something in on the side here. My son's actually in his seventh year at Lee,
okay.
But no, he's been a resident director for the last 3 years, and as he's working on his master's, but that is a great university. Got very, very fond memories of Lee, and I know you do too. It's a great place to go to school. Well, Coach Sig, let's kind of go back to you. I know every now and then we have changes with the coaching staff. Mm-hmm. Just kind of go over who your assistant coaches are this year and what level of helping at.
The only change on our staff has been in our freshman program. Hannah Pennington Shaw, who got married, she was in our program for 3 years. And now they have started a family and has made the decision, which we all fully support, to continue her job during the day but walk away from her coaching responsibilities. And we were very fortunate to get Whitney Mitchell, who played for us and then went on and played at Lee University after playing for us. And now she's back working in the county at Winstead Elementary School and coming over after her day job working with our freshman girls. So it's that's exciting to have someone that has gone through the program and understands what it means to wear Brentwood on your jersey and stress that importance to these young, formidable minds in our on our freshman team.
Make you feel older?
Absolutely.
And when you start coaching
that's coming up pretty quick. I'm
too.
Seeing those mm-hmm. that I coached early in my career at Brentwood now have their children at Brentwood Middle School, so that's closer than we would like to acknowledge.
Right. Well, Matt, let's go back and start with bring us up to date to where the Ravenwood girls are, and then we'll talk about your assistant coaches.
All right. Well, we kind of like Coach Seigenthaler, we also played in a Thanksgiving tournament or classic. We played at Independence. We played Brentwood Academy and in Siegel High School, which kind of gives us a different look than playing our district opponents. Mm-hmm. And then we also played in a Christmas tournament right before the break, and we got to play Oakland and Lancaster Christian out of Rutherford County. So kind of like Coach Seigenthaler, we've been able to play a lot of different types of schools and games. We're very young. We have several sophomores that start for us, a junior and a senior that start. So we're really trying to get them to learn what it means to play on our basketball team. So right now our record, I think, overall is 4-9, but we're 2-2 in the district. So we've gotten off to a decent start in the district, and we're really looking forward to that, playing some very difficult games early on in the season, continuing to hopefully give us some experience down the stretch here.
Mm-hmm. So that experience, I know, is going to add up to district tournament time. You hope your girls are up and ready and playing good. So from what I'm hearing just from the conversation, it looks like Brentwood probably is the team to beat in District 11, AAA. But who would be probably the next team in line after Brentwood?
You know, I tell you, seems like there's a kind of a cluster of teams at this point. Franklin is really good. Dixon County mm-hmm. has a really good player and a good team to go around her. And then I think us and Centennial and Independence are all kind of battling there to kind of get to that next level to compete for that spot to be in the top four to be able to go to the region tournament.
Okay. Well, Coach Sig, let's kind of go back to the Brentwood girls. Kind of go over your starting lineup, what grade they're in, how many years they've been starting or playing for you in your system.
Okay. We've got three seniors that start. H.C. Lackey is our five player. She's a two-year starter. Olivia Sheely is our point guard, another senior. And she has started for about 2.5 years. And then Marissa Anthony is our only other senior, and she starts at our four spot. They have a lot of experience. Just like Coach was saying, his girls are gaining their experience every other day when they're not practicing. They're playing and gaining experience. The other two starters are two juniors that we have, Jesse Boozer, who started at the very end of last year's season, well, halfway through, because Marissa Anthony went down with a knee injury, and then Jesse rolled into that spot, and she's our three guard, and then we were just terribly blessed with a transfer from Oklahoma that moved in as a junior in Jenny Roy, and she has helped this team gain some of this completeness that we have because of her versatility, mm-hmm. particularly on the defensive side, her versatility. She's one of these exceptional athletes that can defend and has defended every position so far in this first half of the season.
Mm-hmm. I guess as far as moving forward, you talked about your freshman coach mm-hmm. and players. I mean, how many do you carry on your varsity then?
We have 14.
Those are non-freshman girls?
Those are non-freshman girls. Okay. We have nine freshman girls. Okay. And the bulk is in our sophomore class.
Okay.
And they have been blessed to have a full JV schedule. And there are 10 sophomores. And we've got just a unique position that all the different positions in basketball are covered within those 10 players. We're not heavy at the post. We're not heavy at the guard. We've got some experience across the board in all the positions, and that is a strong class for us.
Okay. Now, Coach, we're going to back up a little bit. We're going to do basketball 101.
Yes, sir.
All right, basketball 101. You mentioned the 5 spot, and you mentioned the 4 spot. Would you tell the viewers what the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 mean in basketball terminology?
Well, okay. In our system, and we'd really like to think that it's a fundamental system that for a basketball 101 fan, your 1 is your point guard. Your 2 and 3 are your perimeter guards, depending on how you use those in your system. Some people would refer to them as wings. And then our 4 player is more of a forward position instead of an off-post position, and then our 5 player is our post position.
Okay, all right. Well, Matt, let's talk about your team and tell us who your starters are and what year they're in the program there at Ravenwood.
All right. Well, we have at our 5 spot or our center spot, we have Alexis Allert, who she transferred in from Michigan this year. So we both have a transfer that has made our teams a lot better, I think.
Those are answered prayers.
Yes, very much so. Very much so, and she's been tremendous for us. She's a junior. I think she has a great career ahead of her. And then at our 4 spot, we have Megan Hawken, who is a sophomore. She played a little bit on varsity last season for the Ravenwood girls program. And then at our guard positions, our 2 and our 3 spot, they're kind of interchangeable for our team. But we have Colleen Layer, who she's a senior. And she started last year for our girls team. She brings a lot of leadership and experience to our young team. And then at the other guard spot, we have Colin Springer, who is also a junior. And then our point guard spot is Emmy Allen, who is just a sophomore. And she actually started last year on the varsity team. So even though she's a sophomore, she has a lot of experience.
Mm-hmm.
So. Starting a couple sophomores and a couple juniors and a senior.
Mm-hmm. Coach Sieg, you mentioned the junior varsity having a full slate. Mm-hmm. What time does the junior varsity game start tonight?
We're scheduled to start at 3:15 tonight.
Okay, and how have they been doing? JV, they undefeated?
They're undefeated, yes.
Undefeated. Well, it sounds like you got a good pipeline.
Well,
again,
that's a strong class.
And
Coach Carter, and I failed to mention Coach Carter, he is back with me again. David Carter has 25 years of basketball experience, mm-hmm. Been a head coach for the majority of that time, and he and I have been together on 3 different opportunities. We started together, and then as he pursued head coaching experience, we came back together, and now we're back together again. And according to Coach Carter, and I'm going to hold him to it, we're going to do this as long as we can do this.
Okay. And very quickly, Matt, how's your junior varsity girls been doing?
Our junior varsity team is doing pretty good. They're above 500. I want to say they're maybe 6-3 on the season. So they're having a good season, and we're looking forward to watching them growing as well.
Right. Well, thank you guys for joining us today.
Thank you.
And good luck tonight.
Thank you.
Stay with us. We'll be right back in our second session with the boys head coaches.
Hi, I'm Sophia, and this is my book, Black Beauty. I chose this book because I really like the illustrations, and my favorite part is when Black Beauty finds a new owner, Annie. He gets hurt, but the owner takes good care of him. And you could find this book at school or at a store.
Welcome back for the second half of tonight's show. We have the boys' coaches, Coach Patrick Whitlock. I'm going to start with you, Coach, first, because I got a special introduction for the next guy. And then the legendary author, Coach Dennis King of the Brentwood Boys, Coach. Coaches, welcome.
Thanks for having us.
Yeah, and I'm going to start with you, Patrick. The beauty before the age type thing. Wow. Okay.
I don't know, but I appreciate it.
Both of you guys have been on the show before in previous times, so let's go ahead and get into your basketball season up to this point. So, Patrick, tell us how the Raptors have been doing.
Well, we've been incredibly inconsistent. We're 10-6, but we've been a pleasant surprise in district play. We've been able to go 4-0. So very pleased with that, and got a lot of inexperience on our team. It's kind of a day-by-day situation and trying to find the guys that are going to help contribute. But it's a good group, very coachable, and it's been a fun season so far.
Mm-hmm. Now you say 4-0 in the district. Who have you already played? You got a 17 district, right?
Yes, 17 districts, so we'll play 12 games. We opened with Centennial. We made up a game against Independence that following Thursday, and then we played Summit at home all the first and second week of December.
Okay.
And then this past Tuesday, we played Franklin on the road. So it's a little weird having four district games under our belt this early in January, different from what we've been accustomed to.
It is. I know this week is the opening week of the SEC play, and those games have been going on this week. Like Coach Sick said earlier, a lot of times your district games come in after the holidays, but that's a little bit different for District 11, I guess. So,
absolutely.
Coach King, bring us up to date about the Bruins.
We're off to a real good start. We're 18-1, 4-0 in the district, and this is just a great group of kids. Four starters off of the team that. Four guys that started the state tournament last year were back.
Oh.
And so we expected to get out of the blocks quick and early. And but we've had a number of close calls. We're vulnerable. And, this game with Ravenwood has kind of morphed into the biggest game of the year from both student bodies. And it's just one of the most exciting places to be on a winter Friday night.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm sure tonight's game, the gym's going to be full, and the weather has lightened up a little bit. The first part of the week, temperatures were not very good at all. So, but Coach, you said 18-1. Who's that one lost to?
We lost to CPA, who, they're just one
they're
of the
two-time
best.
Two-time
state championships in AA. They've won over 70-some straight games against Tennessee teams. It was a pretty good ball game. It was a three-point game at halftime, and we had it down to two with a couple minutes. But they're really good,
mm-hmm.
And it was a great test, good challenge, and love to see them again.
Mm-hmm. You played 19 games. You played 16 games. What is there a game limit on the number of basketball games you can play? What is that in Tennessee?
You can play. I believe it's 26, but if you play in tournaments, those only count as two games. So sometimes you can get three or four games in.
Oh, okay.
So. And you have played dates, and this is the first time this ever happened. We played two games in one day. Well, you did too. You're allowed to play, as long as it's a play date. You can play any number of games. And so we, in the Christmas tournament at Laverne, which we were both in it, we both played two games. We played at noon, and then we came back and played at 8:30.
Hmm. Okay, that's definitely unusual. I've seen it in AAU tournaments
all
the time,
right?
Because that happens all the time
right.
in those tough tournaments.
And
I've seen it in high school tournament.
And if you win the two, it's fun.
So. Well, it goes into depth of your team.
Absolutely.
And I'm sure you're trying to rest a lot of players, get a lot of people, playing during those type of situations, especially when it's holiday tournaments.
Exactly.
And so you were fortunate to win both of those tournaments?
We did, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So going into tonight's game with Ravenwood, you've been 4-0 and them been 4-0. Who else is in the district that is the next team competition-wise?
Well, Patrick may not agree with me, but I think talent-wise, Franklin is going to be a factor down the road. We're down 9 to them at halftime at home. I had to scratch and claw to get back into it, and I ended up winning by 7 or 8. But they're dangerous.
Mm.
And with a new coach, they're still learning a system, and
sure.
he's still getting to know the players and finding the combinations and the chemistry. Some other teams, you know, I think Centennial can be a sleeper. We had some trouble with Independence. They played deliberate and made us play defense for like 30 seconds at a stretch, and you know, and it was, you know, I think they have a chance to be dangerous. Dixon's a little down, and who's left?
Summit.
Summit's a little down too. Mm-hmm. But we played Summit Tuesday night and jumped on them early, but they keep playing and are well coached, and they have a point guard that gets to the hole. And all these young teams, it's going to be a completely different landscape by February.
All right.
So, you know, you got to win these early ones.
Mm-hmm. Well, Patrick, let's start with you. Start with your assistant coaches. Who's helping you this year since Matt's left you? And go over your starting lineup and what year they are and what positions they're playing for you.
Well, my assistant now in the building is Andrew James. He was our freshman coach last year. He's done a great job. We have a sophomore class we're really high on and we really believe in, and he's kind of built that group up, and now he's moved up with them. Jerry Surratt, who's a Brentwood grad, helps me out. We've converted him a little bit. He's a non-faculty coach. And then our freshman coach is a guy named Scott Farrell, who is now a marketing teacher at Ravenwood and doing a good job with that group.
Okay.
In terms of our starting lineup, it's kind of a very fluid situation. We lost 8 guys last year, mm-hmm. 8 of our top 9, 8 seniors. It was a really heavy class for us. Matthew Haley has kind of been our go-to guy. He's the one guy that was in the rotation last year that's back. Everybody else played sparingly. Nate Fishbach, senior, is our two guard. He's been he stepped up for us and played well. Nick Gleason, our point guard, has arguably been our MVP to this point. He kind of makes us go. It's hard to take him off the floor. And then you know, the pain is being manned by committee. We have a transfer, Van Jefferson, who is a football standout that sure. brings some great athleticism to our team. Case Bolden, Chase Hawkins, another transfer, Brad Newhouse from Utah, has stepped in. But you know, some nights we'll play 10, 11, 12 guys, which is not ideal in a 32-minute game. But you know, there's not a lot of deviation from guy 2 or 3 on our team to guy 13. So we really don't know who's going to step up on any given night.
Okay. Coach King, kind of go over your – Coach Bowser's still with you? And
Coach
your
Boucher.
Coaches,
yeah.
And your lineup.
That's one of the luxuries of being at Brentwood, the stability of the coaching staff. John Boucher has been with me for 18, 19 years. I mean, I could get the stomach flu and cramp up and leave the floor, and they wouldn't miss a beat. There's so much simpatico between us. He knows exactly. We're calling the same thing simultaneously. It's uncanny. Mm-hmm. And Aaron Howard is our ninth grade coach. He's also our strength and conditioning coach. Does an unbelievable job with that in the fall, and you know, I'm just really fortunate to have that kind of stability. And both of them played for me, and they buy into the system, and they are invested in the kids and the school. Now, as far as our personnel, Andy Shumpert is you know, a two-sport athlete. He was great on the football field, and he and Jacob Adcock are inside presence. And Jacob is just kind of a spindly, you know, real quick jumper, and has an uncanny touch. They've gotten the nicknames Surf and Turf because Jacob looks like a surfer boy with his California locks, and mm-hmm. Andy made his reputation on the football field with the turf. So we got Surf and Turf on the inside. Our point guard, who for the first 12 games was Jalen Lawson, and he has blossomed into a pretty good player. Grant Teichman, now I had a player, Kyle Teichman, a few years back, who's in position to become the all-time leading scorer at Freed-Hardeman, and he's about a 6'6", 6'7", force on the inside. His little brother, Grant, is a wing player, and is a gym rat and just loves, I mean, you can't get him out of the gym. The other wing is Jack Batista, was a starter most of last year, and he's had some knee problems, and we're expecting to get him back up to speed, but he plays you know, real good defense, and he's long, and he just has a love for the game like the Teichman kid. James McPherson was our point guard last year, and he missed some games because of some academic problems. He's back in the mix now, and had a nice game Tuesday night. He had 16 against Summit, but he's just kind of a field general. He can see the smallest of windows to deliver the passes, and I'm happy with every position, and we shoot the three pretty well, and we hope to keep on rolling.
Mm-hmm. Well, you mentioned something earlier concerning a team you were playing that was pretty patient, making you play defense for a long period of time before they put the ball up.
Right.
What are your feelings about putting in a shot clock for high school basketball?
That's an interesting question. I'm as old school as they come. Mm-hmm. I think that we have won a lot of games just by spreading them out and running and controlling tempo. And I think with my coaching style, it would be detrimental. But I don't know how much longer I'm going to be coaching. I'm going to end up being a fan. And as a fan, I may want to see a shot clock.
Mm-hmm. So. What about you, Patrick?
I mean, I would love it. I have more of a college background than mm-hmm. high school, even though I've coached longer in high school now after being here 8 years.
But, right.
I like to speed the game up. I don't like it when he pulls it out and holds it. But it's effective and it's hard to guard. So I can see his side of the coin there. But I would like it. I think it's more of a financial thing. I don't think that will happen mm-hmm. anytime soon. Shot clocks are around $1,000. Plus, you got to find somebody to man that thing during a game. So mm-hmm. I think right now that's a pipe dream. There's just a handful of states that have that. So.
Okay. So as far as, that becoming a reality, probably never will take place in the state of Tennessee for a long time.
I think it could. I think there'll be a transition at some point when the National Federation endorses that. Mm-hmm. But I think that's probably 5 to 7 years down the road at least. So, mm-hmm.
Well, who has to play well for you tonight in order to have a chance to beat the Bruins?
It's going to have to be a cohesive team effort. We're going to have to play stingy defense. We're going to have to answer the challenge. I mean, our district is Brentwood and everybody else this year. Mm-hmm. And I think everybody kind of knows that, and we could play a perfect game and still lose. I believe in our kids. I know they're going to play hard and represent our school well, but hopefully it'll be another classic between two great schools and what I consider to be two great programs. It's been a privilege to be a part of this series and this rivalry, not just in basketball, but across the board.
Mm-hmm. Are there any new rules to the game this year? I know sometimes that changes.
Now they've tightened up, or they've said they're tightened up on hand checking and things like that. I think it just depends on the officiating crew you get. Hopefully we'll get a crew tonight that'll call more fouls on the guys in blue than in white.
Oh, okay.
That'll help neutralize some of the mismatches there.
I got you. Well, gentlemen, I appreciate you guys coming in and taking time away from your busy day to do this show, and best of luck tonight and rest of the season. And the girls' JV game will get started probably around 3:15. Then we have a JV boys' game to follow right after that. So the girls' varsity game should start around 6 o'clock, and then after that would be the boys' game.
Right.
It's going to be a big crowd at Ravenwood tonight, so you better get there early to get your seat. Thank you for joining us for the Coach's Preview Show. I'm Jack Daniels, your host.
Light was leaving in the west, it was blue. The children's laughter sang, skipping just like the stones they threw. The voices echoed across the waves. It's getting late.